The White Scars, one of the fastest raiding Space Marine chapters. And now, painting white is often seen as one of the hardest things to do in miniature painting. But if you're working in a simple and grimdark style, it doesn't matter if it's a bit grimy, dusty, dirty, there's a bit of gray in there, and it's not shiny, bright, and white. And then you get a result like this. And I think he looks very, very good. I mean, it's simple to do. It's just some dry brushing, a bit of washing, and then, of course, some detail. And you can push the blood effects as far as you want to go. I actually made them quite bloody because I like the contrast of the red on the white. But, you know, you can keep them clean and instead maybe go for more dust or, you know, keep them as clean as you want. So the White Scar is primed white because it's just easier to start with a white base when you're painting a white mini. And I'm going to wash him all over with some Agrax Earthshade. And the idea is to do this quite lightly, you know, not so heavy. It's just to get some shade in the recesses. After this, we're gonna dry brush all over him again and make him white again. The Agrax Earthshade is dry, and so it's time for a bit of a dry brush with Gray Sear. Now, this is a very light gray, and it's good as a base for your white scars, because you don't want to start with white, because if you start with white, you can't highlight it anymore. So, Gray Sear it is, and then we start brightening it up later. Alright, the dry brush of Grace here is done, and as you can see, he looks a bit creamy and there's still a little bit of shade in the recesses. Now I'm going in with a Praxiti white, and this is a pure white dry brush paint, so you have to be very careful with this. You really only want to hit the edges. And if you put too much of this on it, it's going to be very hard to fix, so slowly, slowly build up your highlights. Here he is after the dry brush of Praxiti White. He looks dusty, but I think that will look good in the end. So now it's time for some detailing, and I'll start with a Batten Black on the joints, in the armor, and the weapons. Okay, the black is done, and he's starting to look like a bit of a stormtrooper. So let's change that and make him look like a White Scars Space Marine instead. I'm gonna start with some Corn Red on the Aquila. And I'm going to do some other red details as well, such as the purity seal and the handle of the chainsword. And the corn red is done. As you can see, I painted way more than just the Aquila and the chainsword handle. I went for the knee pad and the trim on the shoulder pads as well, and the eyes. Because when I was done with the Aquila and the handle, I looked at him and he was just way too white. And I'm not using the White Scars shoulder pad. I can't freehand a nice icon on his knee pad. So I figured I would just paint the knee pad red and paint the trim red as well. That way you get a bit more red, a bit more color, and it looks a bit more like a White Scar as well. So now on to the leather, and I'm using Mournfang Brown for this. And I'm going all over the holster and the belt and all the pouches with this, with one layer. All right, Mournfang Brown is done. And while I was doing the belt, I figured I'd do the belt buckle black as well. Just adding a bit more black contrasts more with the white, and it makes the white look whiter. So now for some lead belcher, and I'm going to do the gun, the teeth of the chainsword, and the vents on the backpack. All right, the lead belcher is done on the vents on his backpack and the weapons. It's time for some small gold details. And I'm using Retributor armor for this. This is a very bright yellow gold. And I normally don't do this when I paint it grimdark, but I think the White Scars can use a bit more color. You know, black and white is just black and white. So I'm using a bright yellow colored gold. And I'm just doing this icon on his hand and the cross guard on his sword. And I might do a few details on the gun as well. We'll see. Don't forget to hit that like button if you're enjoying this video. And I want to give a quick shout out to my patrons. Thank you guys so much for your support. You make this channel possible. Alright, the gold details are done on the hand and the sword, and on the other side I just painted these two little dots gold. I didn't really see any space on the gun for any gold details, so that will just have to do. And now it's time for a bit of cleanup, because I touched the white here and there with the other paints. And for this, I'm using Ceramide White, and I've watered it down quite a bit. And this Ceramide White is the same color as the Praxiti White, it's just not a dry paint, it's a base paint. Now you have to be quite careful with this. Now, very lightly stipple on where you paint it over the white. And that way you don't get a big blotch of white in its place. You get somewhat of the mottled look that you get with the rest of the armor from the dry brushing. So for example here, just dab on very gently, and there you go, fixed. Okay, cleanup is done, and I realized I forgot the parchment of the purity seal. So I'm going over this with Rockart Flesh. It's a nasty brown grayish color, and I think it's great for this parchment. So then it's time to shade all the little details, and I'm using non-oil for this because I want a black shade so that it again contrasts a bit better with the white. And you have to be careful with this, you really don't want to get any of this on your white armor because it's very hard to clean that up again. You'll have to redo the white and maybe even redo some of the dry brushing. So be careful and work very patiently. The non-oil has dried. And now it's time to give a little bit of a highlight to all the red parts. And I'm just using corn red for this, which is the same red that I used for the base layer. I'm just trying to get it on all the edges and make sure it just doesn't go into the recesses and you'll get a decent enough highlight. If you do get it in the recesses, you can always go over it again with non-oil and then highlight again with some corn red. So the Aquila has just a little bit of corn red as a highlight, and so does the shoulder pad trim. And now I'm gonna highlight the gun and the chainsword with a little bit of lead belt. I'm just gonna dry brush it on. Just hit those edges, it will make them shine a bit, it will give them a bit of scratched and damaged look at the same time. And while we have the lead belcher out, I'm gonna add some scratches and sort of battle damage to his armor. And I'm just stippling on some lead belcher here on his boots. So you can imagine them knocking over rocks and so on and getting scratched and dented and the paint scraping off. And I'm using it as a little bit of a dry brush around the edges everywhere. And there he is with a little bit of battle damage on his boots, the knee pads, the trim of the shoulders, really everywhere, and especially some damage on the vents because you can imagine the paint just flaking off if it gets too hot. And now I'm gonna paint the base, and if you have a keen eye you can see that there's already texture on the base. That's because this is an old model. I just sprayed him over to make this video, and so normally I would use something like Astral Granite Debris. That's a green texture paste that Citadel, Games Workshop, sells. And instead of that, I'm now just painting it Ashen Grey, because that's pretty much the same color. So while the base is drying, I'm going to add a little bit more detail to the model. I want to get some black on this vent, because I'm assuming it's a heat vent from the backpack there. And just getting some black on there makes it look like the white paint has come off. And there's still some primer showing through. So I'm assuming that in the Space Marine world, they prime their armor before they paint it as well. And it kind of looks like soot as well. And I'm going to do the same with the stabilizers and these vents here, just to get a bit more black in there, makes the white looks whiter. And it gets a bit more interesting in a mini that has so little color. And you can see the vent now, it looks dirty, it almost looks like it has some soot on there, but mainly it's damaged clearly. So that's another way to show some battle damage or worn out armor without resorting to rust, because rust on a Space Marine's armor for me feels really out of place, because rust, it's not just a sign of decay, it's a sign of neglect. You know, you get rust if you don't take care of your armor, and I don't believe that Space Marines and everybody that serves them would leave the armor to rot away and rust. Anyway, let's get some dust on his boots. So I'm using Ashen Grey, the same color that I used to paint the base. And I'm just dry brushing it on, moving from bottom to top, but also from top to bottom. And I'm just making sure it gets on the boots and a bit on the lower legs as well. And here he is with dusty boots. Now the base still needs to dry, I'm gonna wash it later. So while it's drying, I'm just going to make the eyes pop a little bit more. And I'm using Evil Sun's Scarlet for this. There, now the eyes look a bit more brighter, a bit more as if they're glowing. And now I'm just gonna wash the base with some non-oil to get a bit more texture in there, a bit more shading, and also to darken it down a bit more. So it's pretty much done. And now for the final touches, I'm going to add some blood for the Blood God. I'm going to start with the chainsword and with a dry brush, and not too much of it on there. I'm just going all over at least the teeth and making sure that it stays here in the middle of the chainsword, you know, where you would hit the models with. Make sure to do the underside, because it'll go on both sides. And then let's dab on some on his hand for sure. Shoulder pad, get some blood spatters over there. Some on his leg over here. You know, anything on this side is probably getting splattered with blood and gore. And that's my White Scars Assault Intercessor done. I think it looks good. I mean, white, yeah, it's still tough to paint, but it's really not as hard as it's made out to be if you're going for a simple and grimdark style. Because then you can make mistakes, you can leave it smudgy, you can make it gray, and it still looks good. And it looks, you know, as if it's supposed to look like that. Now, if you enjoyed this simple grimdark tutorial, then don't forget to like and subscribe. And check out my simple grimdark painting series, because there's a lot more there. I've also got an Instagram, a Facebook page, and Patreon. So if you want to support me, you can find links to all of those things in the description below. Thanks for watching. See you next time.